Hello, it's Average Roe, and welcome back to Mass Effect 3. Jumping right into it again, as has been the trend for the past couple sessions, because we have a lot on our table. You know, I'm always so excited to just keep playing, but then the more I play, the closer I get to the end, you know, and we're getting really close, guys. On the agenda today, we are finishing all of the side missions, not counting DLC, but we're finishing all side missions. And by all, I mean literally one. There's one more side mission left that we need to do. And other than that, we're gonna be traveling to the Citadel real quick just to submit our final Citadel side mission stuff. And that's it. So basically we're finishing side missions today. And then we are going to be heading over to the, I'm trying to think of which one I want to do first. Basically, we're doing the Priority Horizon mission. That's our big story mission for today. And we're also going to be finishing the Leviathan DLC. So yeah, finishing side missions, the Leviathan DLC, and doing Priority Horizon. This is not where I want to go, actually. This is Horizon. Where is that... N7 mission. Usually it's highlighted. Oh, here it is. Yeah, here we go. Kepler Verge. My bad. But, yeah, if you're new, we are a Paragon Femship Vanguard, and I have played through the Legendary Edition for the first time from Mass Effect 1 all the way up until now. And, this is it's a combination I've never done before, so, I'm having lots of fun with it. I have played through the original version of the trilogy several times before, though. But either way, even though this isn't a true blind playthrough, consider sticking around if that's what you're originally looking for, because again, we're having lots of fun. But let's go ahead and just take James and Edie. Yeah. Wait, am I taking Edie on? No. Okay, so yeah, let's take Edie. Cool. We've been seeing lots of James recently. You know, I like to give him his due time. You know, he doesn't often get enough time during like the main story stuff, so you know I try to at least give him some love in these side missions and whatnot. So okay, confirm that. Edie, I imagine, is gonna have a lot. Yeah, I like all of his powers, so it looks like I've just been keeping it pretty consistent. Extra damage. More damage, kind of. Just more damage. have you caught on to the trend? Yeah. The recharge speed is already fine, so don't really need to pump any more into that. But we can finally max out James's fortification. Just give him extra damage protection. Really nice. We're looking really strong, guys. Okay. This is our last N7 mission ever. Feels kind of surreal.
Commander Cerberus has taken one of our secret.
But I mean, this is just a bunch of mumbo jumbo. It's another multiplayer map, I believe.
What do we know?
We're getting intel from a tech who
survived the attack. But we have a lot more important stuff going on right now. Don't want to spend too much time here.
A civilian?
We'll just go in, shoot some people, and save somebody.
Miss Sato, what's happening down there?
As per usual.
But I'm the only one left. They're trying to hack into our system.
Now there is one last thing we can find for the Citadel on here. So then after this,
we'll
make a quick pit stop at the Citadel to submit that mission and then do that Elcor thing that we messed up in the previous session. And then we'll be done at the Citadel. The standard Citadel, really, because we will be doing the Citadel DLC.
I'll take care of it, Admiral.
Which will be starting next session, hopefully. So really exciting stuff. But hopefully this doesn't take us too long. It's a little tricky, a lot of close quarter fighting, but as a Vanguard, I'm a little more confident than I was in my last time playing the original version of this trilogy as a infantry. Let's make sure everyone's using the weapons I want them to use. Let's have Edie use a pistol. Why not? Get the ammo powers on.
Out to me. Moving out of
Chateau, we've landed. What are we looking at?
I'm gonna go ahead and just grab the Citadel thing real quick.
I'm updating your nav point with the location of the terminal. They're closest to cracking.
Cerberus encryption algorithms of some sort.
Yep, plasma shotgun doesn't mess around. Oh god. Neither do those turrets. Oh! Almost killed it in one shot there. I just recently got this gun, so excuse my fanboying over it, but this is my favorite gun. I was so excited to finally get this. Why are you running? I mean, this is like, we're just casually strolling through here. Don't mind me. Dang it. Oh, there we go. I was hoping they wouldn't shoot me since I was dumb enough to start that out in the open. Come on, hurry, hurry, hurry! Oh, come on! Alright, you deserve that one. Okay, anyone else want to rudely interrupt me?
Miss Sato, come in. Miss Sato, are you there?
Must be afraid to break radio silence.
We need the final coordinates. Grace, listen to me.
Can't talk. They're right outside.
Come on, Grace. Do you know who I am? I can rescue you.
I won't let you down, I promise.
Okay. Well, let's go this way. Whoops. Close there. This gun is just ridiculous. Don't peek if you know what's good for you. Don't want to start this deactivation, but let's see if we can just get it out of the way. Real quick.
Commander, they've almost got the doors open. Help!
Got her covered, Commander. Area cleared. Picking up Miss Sato.
Okay, that should be it, right?
Good job, Lieutenant.
Cool. Alright, that was it. A little unceremonious, but either way, get out the fanfare, because that is it for side missions in this game.
Our communication station is secure. Operations in this theater are safe again. No small task to keep it that way. How's Miss Sato doing?
She has to be transferred to a nearby Alliance station. She wants to help however she can.
Good. We need all the help we can get. Hack it out.
Okay. Depending on whether to make my Normandy rounds and talk to people. But I don't think... Yeah. We'll do that after we visit the Citadel. So let's make our last ever visit to the Alliance Docks Citadel version. Yeah, see, these two don't even have anything new to say. Okay, did that. All right. But I'm really excited to get to Horizon. It's a very challenging mission, in my opinion. And of course, finishing the Leviathan DLC is also going to be quite fun.
Cleared to dock, Normandy. Do you need ground transport?
Embassies, please.
I need to get to the embassies.
Yes, Commander. We got your people off to Kuna, Ambassador.
Utterly sincere. Thank you for your assistance, Commander. This is not a deputy captain.
Were you able to evacuate any civilians?
I don't want to interrupt them.
How many?
Refugee camps in the Citadel are straining existing resources.
Sad Elcor noises.
No, I know what I said. Divert forces to the new coordinates. Trust me. We may not be able to stop the Reapers, but I think we can predict.
Who is this Officer Delk? Is that who the Cerberus Cyphers are or Cyphers are for?
My wife was just sent back to active duty and I'm about to get shipped out too. I was told you might be able to help me.
I think it might be over here. I don't remember going into this corner. Yes.
Your intel, right?
Cool.
I found these encryption codes on a Cerberus engineer.
That should be it.
Helpful.
All right, let's check our journal. Feels good. Look at all those side missions, just completely done. Completely done. Couldn't even make it through all of them. But let's just see if Jacob's there. Yeah, everyone's just normal spots. Let's get out of here. It was nice knowing you, Citadel. You're my favorite version of the Citadel in Mass Effect. But, you know, while we're here, why don't we just...
Please select the destination.
Let's do the Leviathan DLC first. Let's finish the Leviathan DLC. I'm trying to think if there's a reason why I would have said do Horizon first. But,
Now arriving at
they're both really big missions, so, like either mission could serve as its own finale to a stream session anyway. You know, I usually try to save like the biggest mission for last, but they're both huge, so. But if we're already here, why don't we'll just head over to Bryson's lab and do the Leviathan DLC. I feel like also lore-wise that's a little more urgent. I guess, because like last we heard, you know, we had Anne Bryson and we were tracking down whatever. And Horizon, like, we just know that, like, it's just a small lead, you know what I mean? But, I don't know, I'm just trying to justify doing Leviathan DLC first. But it doesn't quite matter in the end, I don't believe. But this is our second to last DLC. The last DLC, of course, being the Citadel DLC. So, as per usual with this one, we are going to be poking around Bryson's lab to find our final lead. But I think Anne is here this time. Oh, she's mourning her father. That's right.
Hello? Anne? You here?
Commander. Yes, I'm sorry. Just... This is hard.
Of course. You all right?
Yes. No. I don't know. My father and I didn't leave things in a great state.
An argument?
Yes.
That's the worst.
It was trivial. A disagreement on how to file some of the specimens. I was mad about something else. I don't remember what. I took it out on him. So stupid.
That's all right. I can come back.
No, please. I'm okay. Seeing all this again? He was so obsessed. Crazy sometimes.
I didn't get a chance to know him.
Oh, sometimes I felt the same way. He was a great man. A pioneer. But he could be distant. I felt like an inconvenience growing up.
You sound angry.
I was angry. Still am, I guess. But sometimes, he was so full of stories, he nearly burst. I loved that about him. It's why I signed up for this work. I can't believe he's gone.
We'll figure this out.
We have to. I need to know what's on the other end of that artifact. What he died for.
We'll get there.
Your help. You're our last chance.
You're right. Let me dig into my father's work to see what I can find.
Anne, you sure you're up for this?
Yes. When Leviathan took control of me, I remember being somewhere cold and dark.
The darkness must not be breached.
My father,
or cannot be breached.
Never be afraid of the dark.
Okay. Let's get this show on the road. Edie's outfits have been changing. Like, the last Leviathan mission when we were here, she was wearing the dark outfit. And then when we just did the N7 mission, she was wearing the white one. And now she's not wearing any outfit. I don't know what's going on with Edie right now, but...
I'm still amazed your father got his hands on a piece of a Reaper.
He was so excited. Your claims validated years of work.
Did you take appropriate steps to prevent indoctrination?
Of course. It was completely shielded, and we all had regular psyche valves. But now, thanks to the artifact, I'm indoctrinated anyway, aren't I? Might as well be a Arachnide drone waiting for orders from the Queen.
You studied the Arachnide?
I wrote my dissertation on them. My father thought it was a waste of time, but now it might actually help us understand Leviathan.
In what way?
We think of the Arachnide as telepathic, but there's really no such thing. At short range, the Queen uses pheromones to give orders. At long range, she uses an organic kind of quantum entanglement communicator. Whatever Leviathan does must be similar, entangling particles to stimulate neural activity. It uses the artifact to establish a connection, and then it controls the mind of anyone near it.
Hmm.
Hey, Lola. Need a hand?
Oh, what's James doing here?
What brings you down here, James?
Saw what happened to Anne back at the dig site. That ain't right.
Well, make yourself comfortable. We didn't detect any energy emissions from the artifact.
But the Reapers were able to use the artifact to trace Leviathan somehow.
My theory is that most of the time, the artifact simply acts as a receiver. We'll only be able to trace Leviathan through it when it actively takes control of someone.
As it did on the asteroid.
Right. Unless it needs something, Leviathan doesn't bother communicating. I guess it and my father had something in common.
Oof.
You said Leviathan's control was similar to a quantum entanglement communicator, which is untraceable.
Yes. But this isn't a natural QEC. Leviathan has to send a pulse through the artifact to alter your mind and create the quasi-QEC effect.
And that can be traced.
Right. Just like at the dig site. The Reapers were tracing the signal by activating the artifact. My father wanted to be at that dig site. He was getting too old for long digs, but he hated being stuck in the lab. He nearly missed my graduation because he was on a dig. Showed up still wearing his field gear. God, he'd have hated dying here.
And I know this is hard, but if there's anything more...
Anne's doing a lot of the heavy lifting for us.
I don't think
her hand just phased through her shoulder.
But maybe I can show you.
What are you saying?
The artifact only sends out a signal when Leviathan's controlling someone. So let it control me. You could trace the signal.
You mean let it take you over? That's too dangerous.
It's my call, not yours. You said I'm your last chance to find this thing.
We have no idea what will happen.
If we wait, the Reapers will get to Leviathan first. I'm the only one here who's spent enough time with it to do this. You're looking for something to fight the Reapers, Commander. I'm looking for the monster that murdered my father.
We still don't know what we're looking for.
Then let's find out.
There's a bunch of interrupts.
This thing we're doing with Ann sounds dangerous as hell.
Noted. Edie?
Energy signature locked in. Waiting for activation.
You sure about this?
Yes. I'm sure.
I'm gonna be right here.
Okay. I'm ready.
James, drop the containment shield.
Shield is dropped.
Artifact online.
Anything?
Nothing yet. Wait. There's something. I feel a chill.
Edie?
So freaking weird.
Holy hell!
Signal is tracking. Maintain connection.
Turn back. The darkness can't be breached.
No!
Maintain connection.
Listen to me. I found you, and the Reapers are right behind me.
You have brought them.
You are a threat.
So are you. I've seen what you can do. The war needs you.
There is no war. There is only the harvest.
Edie, do we have enough?
Partial lock. Maintain connection to narrow the search.
You heard her. We got enough. I'm hitting the shield.
Belay that, Lieutenant.
Signal is fading. Maintain connection.
We can fight them. We can win this.
The cycle cannot be broken.
You're wrong.
Sounds just like
focus
a Reaper.
On the point of origin. Maintain connection to narrow the search.
I think she's gonna be okay.
I'm stopping this.
I think she'll be okay.
Where are
I have I haven't checked it again.
Where are
the like what happens, but I think it'll be okay.
Trace complete.
James.
Got it. Okay. Yeah.
She's good, we're right? Good. She's good.
Shit.
Anne, talk to me.
She's a mess.
She good though?
Edie, did we get it?
We have a location.
Nice. hang in there. And she got us the single location.
I'm taking her to med lab.
I think it would have been like...
See you back on the Normandy.
We had to like search it. You know what I mean? Search for it. If we didn't get what we needed right away. But, I mean, we have the single location, so we should be able to leave now, right? Yeah, we should be able to go right away. Let me just, because this will be the last time we're here. So let me just make sure, double check, there's nothing we need to do. Yeah, I think if we cut off the connection by letting James activate the shield, we would have had to, like, do one more look-see. You know what I mean? But I think since we, had Anne take the brunt of the damage for us, we were able to just bypass all of that, so I think it was worth it. I think she ends up being okay too, so I hope. Alright, so we are gonna head to what we believe to be the Leviathan's lair. Exciting stuff. I'm just gonna look to see if anyone's standing anywhere weird. No. Okay. I'll do a Normandy rounds after we do this Leviathan DLC. Just, you know, just because I don't want. I never like going too long without doing that. but we've only done like a bunch of, you know, side stuff recently, so. Oh man, Sigurd's Cradle, only 57%. I don't think I have my guy here, the rest of Sigurd's Cradle. So that might be a problem. Whoops. Dang. Yeah, I definitely don't have all of that, I don't think. Shoot. Well, I might save that for off screen. Yeah, off screen I'll fly around, because I forgot that when making this planet scanning guide, again, since I've beaten the game already, I forgot that the Leviathan DLC unlocks a bunch of new stuff, so.
Signal confirmed.
Just make sure there's nothing else hidden here. But that should be it. To remember to do that now. Do that off screen, or maybe if I find myself with some time.
These coordinates match our trace of Leviathan.
At the end of a session or something, I'll like do like a quick cleanup, but okay. We're good to go. The Leviathan finale. Now, I'm gonna be honest. I've only done the Leviathan DLC, like, I think this is maybe my third time doing it. No more than fourth time doing it. And I'm still not 100% on, like, knowledgeable, like, on board with how the Leviathan's lore feeds in to the existing lore, the established lore with the core game. You know, because if you've played the Leviathan DLC, you'll know that there's a lot of lore that is expanded upon in this DLC, which is great, really good, but I'm still a little fuzzy, so if I get some facts wrong, you'll have to excuse me for those diehard Mass Effect fans out there that can recite the codex entries of every single Mass Effect game. But, oh, no upgrades available, so heading straight in, I guess. Very quiet.
Cortez, what's the status on the probe we launched?
Tracking it now, Commander. I've confirmed that Leviathan's signal originates from this planet. Heard how Anne helped us locate it. It's pretty spooky stuff.
She's a trooper, though.
Never seen anything like it. Can't imagine what's waiting for us down there.
A Reaper killer. That is all that matters. Even if it doesn't want to be found.
Been taking Javik a lot as well recently. Which is always fun.
Sure, but now what? Let's suppose it is a Reaper. Is that the kind of help we want?
Nobody says we have to be friends with it, but if this thing has the rest of the Reapers worried, then we need its help.
Commander, new readings from the probe. It's narrowed down Leviathan's location. You're not gonna like it.
Let's hear it.
There's nothing but ocean. I show a concentration of structures floating on the surface, but the probe's giving us a signal below that. Way below.
Underwater?
Looks that way. The shuttle should still be able to reach it.
Possible?
Kodiak is spec to nearly 1,000
atoms. So it's similar to the Shadow Broker's base in Mass Effect 2, where they came up with really good reasons as to why he was never found. So now we're seeing why, just how this Leviathan was never found.
Worse, Commander.
How's the shuttle, Cortez?
Checking now. I'll see if I can get power restored.
Copy that. We'll look around.
Must have ships, makeshift shelters. We're not the first ones down by that pulse.
Could be Leviathan's last line of defense. Any idea how
old enough not to stink?
There's a bunch of stuff to pick up here, so I'm trying to
find it. Looks like one of those artifacts.
Explains why no one gets out of here.
Let's get rid of that guy.
I'm not recognizing any of those ships. They're ancient.
Oh man, I missed the talking opportunity. Or I guess it was just a visual. I don't think there was any conversation to be had there. Yeah, a lot of these ships out here don't seem of recent make. And it's kind of similar to when we went through the Omega 4 relay. And all the ships on the other side of it were just a bunch of ancient ships we didn't recognize. Should have enemies dropping in here soon, I think. But, might be everything. Oh, here's stuff. That was our third one, right?
Look up there! Reapers, Commander! They were right behind
Jesus.
Us!
Protect the shuttle! Just flying right in. Because this is what we need to advance the story, so... I suppose that that's what we needed to, interact with.
Lieutenant, situation? Swap me out the parts, Commander! Hang on!
Oh god. I actually think I like this gun against him more. In. Where are they? Oh, jeez, what the? That was weird. I wonder if that was intentional. There you go, Cortez. I'm in trouble. Cortez, hang in there, buddy. There's so many of them. Missile launcher.
Status.
Shuttle's a mess, Commander. That pulse knocked it right out of the air. We're not going anywhere.
The Normandy could extract us.
Same thing would happen to her. And the landing won't be as pretty. I'd say Leviathan has some sort of defense system in place.
Then we aren't getting out of here until we find it. So how do we do that?
Well, you might be able to use a mech. Looks like it's rigged for diving.
A diving mech?
It Triton model. Military grade, repurposed for deep sea exploration. As long as the seawater hasn't corroded, it should be good to go.
Well, if that's what we have to do, let's get started.
Wait a second. Are we seriously saying you're gonna...
First, we'll need to restore power to get that cargo door open.
How?
It appears we are.
These old Ballard-class ships are equipped with exterior...
we gotta get the combat all out of the way here, because the rest... once we get in that mech, there's really no fighting at all.
Hang on, I'll get you started.
It's all just a bunch of talking.
Find somewhere to plug that in.
Oh, I hate this part. Let's just see if we can use our powers with it. So we're good to use our powers.
Another power cell for you, Commander. The enemy is persistent. Get another power cell, Commander. We'll hold them off.
It's crazy how fast we shred those guys. Working with Cortez in the field here. Another reason why I like taking James with us on this. Come on, yes.
Cargo doors are opening, Commander. That mech is all yours. It should still have weapons capability.
I like the sound of that. Kill enemies. Last time we were in this was at Grissom Academy, I think. God, I don't think we hit it. You want some? Like, trapped. That was funny. Oh, instant kill. Satisfying.
That did it. Looks like we're in the clear now, Commander.
Good. I need to get in the water before they come back.
Roger that. Walk the mech back to me when you're ready to dive. I should check it over first.
Well, so taking Edie here wouldn't make much sense if, like, EMP pulses are being shot out, right? Wouldn't that, like, damage her or something?
All right, Commander. Let's get you out of there and I'll do a systems check.
Whoa. Hey, Commander, are you really serious about this plan?
It's honestly crazy, but...
we've come too far to stop now. The way home is through Leviathan.
Okay, SEALs, check out. Oxygen pressure is nominal. Systems are a go. It's as ready as I can make it.
Let's go.
Take care down there, Commander.
Closing hatch.
Here we go, guys. Here we go. Super unique
comm link.
Sequence here, unlike any other part of Mass Effect.
Here goes.
Commencing dive in 3, 2, 1.
Got a really cool loading screen as well. Just ancient. Ancient.
So far? Copy that. Cortez? Cortez!
Sweaty palms, man. We're just falling this entire time. Just going deeper and deeper, man. What being are the Reapers afraid of? What being has similar powers to a Reaper? Sounds like kind of like a Reaper. Those ancient cave drawings kind of look like a Reaper. What kind of creature is this Leviathan? It's the mystery behind it all is just the best part of this for me. I love this DLC. I like taking Javik with us because it's like,
not sure if you can read
in Mass Effect
1,
we think Protheans are just the most ancient, said. You know, but as the game goes on, we realize they're nothing compared to what came before, like the Inusana or previous cycles. And that's why I like taking Javik on this DLC, because we thought Javik was ancient. The Leviathan is just a whole nother level of ancient.
Shutting down all non-critical systems to preserve remaining power. Not sure how much juice the emergency thruster will need to get me back to the surface. Don't worry about that now.
This is honestly insane. Just flying by the seat of our pants.
Seen some strange readings from the probe. Something is definitely down there.
The suspense. I'm not doing that, by the way. I think it automatically shoots out those flares.
Reading the probe directly.
3,120 meters below surface. I'm not smart enough to really know or have like the scope, you know, the knowledge to understand the scope of that. Like,
can't see anything just yet. Probe seems intact. I'm gonna keep moving.
The probe. Let's see. I'm looking up how deep we are. Yeah, we're like 2 miles below the surface, just vertically downward. 2 miles below. So what could live in the water this deep?
That?
I see bubbles. We found them, guys. It's insane. It's a look at him. Darkness can be breached.
They are the enemy. One that seeks our extermination.
But I thought you were a Reaper.
Not quite.
They are only echoes. We existed long before.
Then what are you?
Something. Your memories give voice to our words. Your nature will be revealed to us. Accept this.
The galaxy's at war with the Reapers. You defeated one. Why aren't you fighting back?
There is no war. There is only the harvest.
Then help us stop it.
None have possessed the strength in past cycles. Your own species could be destroyed with a single thought. But you are different. I have witnessed your actions in this cycle. The destruction
of quite the pedigree.
The fall of the collectors. The Reapers perceive you as a threat. And I must understand why.
one makes me bleed my own blood.
Cycles, our kind was the apex of life in the galaxy.
Here's the lore.
The lesser species were in our thrall, serving our needs. We grew more powerful.
This is before the cycles.
But we could not protect them from themselves. Over time, the species built machines that then destroyed them. Tribute does not flow from a dead race. To solve this problem, we created an intelligence with a mandate to preserve life at any cost.
Some sort of AI, right?
As the intelligence evolved, it studied the development of civilizations. Its understanding grew until it found a solution. In that instant, it betrayed us. It chose our kind as the first harvest. From our essence, the first reaper was created. You call it
the enemy.
Harbinger.
You built that machine despite what you saw the other races experience. Why?
You cannot conceive of a galaxy that bends to your will. Every creature, every nation, every planet we discovered became our tools. We were above the concerns of lesser species. The intelligence was envisioned as simply another tool.
And now we all pay the price for your mistake.
There was no mistake. It still serves its purpose.
How did the intelligence defeat you?
To find a solution, it required information. Physical data drawn from organic life in the cosmos. It created an army of pawns that searched the galaxy, gathering this data. There was no warning. No reason given when they turned against us. Only slaughter. Only the harvest.
Tell me about the Reapers.
Each harvest ends with the birth of a Reaper, perfect in its design. Each formed in Harbinger's image. Our image.
Leviathan created.
Each Reaper has the power to influence organics. Over countless cycles, this ability was refined, perfected, and gave rise to indoctrination.
How did you remain hidden all this time?
Our extermination was not complete. Some survived and found refuge in the dark corners of the galaxy. I am their progeny. Over the cycles, the thrall races were controlled, removing traces of our existence as we directed them to. In this way, our survival was kept secret from the Reapers. Today, we reach out through the fragments and watch for discovery.
Right? And we found them all over the galaxy, so...
I mean the artifacts we found.
They provide a window into the galaxy. Tools for exploring the events of this cycle for the safety of this world. Through them, we watch, we study, and remain in the shadows.
What do you know about the Crucible?
We have watched its construction before. It has never been completed. Those who have tried still fell victim to the
We learned from the Thessia Prothean VI that the Crucible has been attempted to be made throughout several cycles.
You are an anomaly,
and Leviathan knows of it and knows it's never been done before.
The cycle will continue.
No! You've been watching. You know this cycle is different.
Mm-hmm.
We will survive. You will remain here as a servant of our needs. The Reapers will harvest the rest.
Release me. No one has to be harvested.
Nothing will change.
The Reapers know where you are. You can't just watch anymore. You have to fight. Even if you survive the battle today, the Reapers won't stop. Ever. Release me and we have a chance to end this once and for all.
I've earned it. Out there fighting where you should be.
It's clear why the Reapers perceive you as a threat. Your victories are more than a product of chance. We will fight, but not for you or any lesser race. We were the first, the Apex race. We will survive. And the Reapers who trespass on this world will understand our power. They will become our slaves. Today, they pay their tribute in blood.
I like the sound of that. Lot to digest there, but I still friggin' love that conversation. It kind of bolsters the ending conversation with Crucible at the end of Priority Earth. Just expands a little bit more. Oh, our friends need help. Bye, Mac. Nope. Leviathan says no.
Shepard's back. How we doing, Cortez?
Out of there, guys. Random husk. Remember how in Mass Effect 2, like, the Reapers and the Collectors were trying to create a new Reaper, and it looked like a human?
Commander, wake up!
Well...
She's freezing!
The original Reapers were based off of... In the same way, were based off of the Leviathan, which is why they look the way they do.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm fine. Hell of a headache.
We're lucky we got you back.
What happened down there?
We found it. It's real. A lot more than we ever imagined.
So was it worth almost dying for?
I don't know. But we proved it can't hide anymore. It's a part of this war just like us. And it's gonna help fight.
Sounds like a hell of a story.
Yeah. One for the history books.
Dang. So that's it. That's the end of the Leviathan DLC.
Commander, I finished reading your report.
Finish this conversation with
Hackett.
The Alliance
wanted more intelligence on the Reapers. I'd say we got it.
Our people will be studying it for years to come. They're already calling it the Leviathan Codex. It rewrites galactic history as we know it.
Whatever else it means, it tells me the Reapers had a beginning. And maybe now we'll provide them with an end.
That's one way to look at it. I guess it's the only way. So go out there and make it happen. This is a big step in the right direction, Shepard. Good work.
Thank you, sir.
Hack it out.
Okay. Dominate. That's a new ability. Leviathan enthrallment team, right? Because they can control troops and send them out. I mean, that looks like a max bar to me. I'm pretty sure it's like somewhere in 8,000 is like the maximum. I don't know the exact number. But yeah, I mean, especially after in the original, like original version of the game where it took galactic readiness from the multiplayer into account. Like the galactic readiness added some sort of modifier to your number to get the final number. You know what I mean? Which is what people didn't like, because that effectively meant the multiplayer influenced the single player. So the Extended Edition got rid of that, and I assume the Legendary Edition is the same way. So I'm not quite sure what the number is that is needed to get the perfect ending, or like what the maximum number is.
Commander?
Trainer's got nothing to say. Edie should have something to say. She was pretty involved with the Leviathan. But this is our pre-Horizon rounds, I guess you could call it.
Joker, you asked for news about the human colony, Tiptree.
That's where his family is.
Hey, Liara, you don't need to worry about that right now.
Now's as good a time as any. I'm getting reports of refugee ships from Tiptree landing on Solarian colonies. I don't have names. I'm sorry. It was mostly children.
Well, Gunny, Hillary, my sister, Gunny's the nickname she's had it since. She's only 15, so if it's children, then maybe I only lost my dad. Kind of an asshole thing to hope for.
Jeff, right now, take any kind of hope you can get.
That's tough.
Thanks. You too.
That's tough. I do know that there's a way to figure out what happened to his family through, like, side conversations and, like, data entries, I think. I've never really looked into that, though, but, yeah, it does
Commander,
suck for Joker to go through that.
So the Reapers did not fully exterminate their creators. That suggests they are fallible, even on large or long-term scales.
How's the ship holding up, Edie?
The envelope of mass-free space we create when we travel at FTL limits any impact of micro-collisions with ambient dust. Nevertheless, some ablation does occur at subluminal speeds. Normandy will need maintenance before the year is out.
If we live that long, I will totally spring for it.
Hello, Shepard.
So, just to recap the Leviathan, I feel like the Leviathans are... They became like the apex organic being, and they noticed that the other organic species that were lesser than them like kept killing each other or like creating machines that eventually would destroy them, you know. So they created an AI themselves and programmed it and said, your one goal is to figure out how to preserve organic life, and it came up with a solution, you know, and that was to create the Reapers, which to my understanding, the logic behind that is, you know, well, they killed the Leviathan. Well, they thought they killed the Leviathans and used them to create the first Reaper ever, which is Harbinger, who, you know, we faced off against in Mass Effect 2.
I've been thinking about what we learned, Shepard. The thing is, I don't really care what the Reapers are or where they're from. They're monsters that need to be put down. That's all I need to know.
Hey there.
Yeah. I mean, I do agree. They do need to be dealt with. But in what way? We'll see. We will see. If you be in the game, you know what I'm talking about.
Take care, Commander.
Let's see what that dominate power does. Disrupt the synaptic harmonics of an organic brain so it can't differentiate between friend and foe. Oh, okay. So, it's exactly what it did at the end of the cutscene there, where it like controlled one of the brutes. That's cool. I don't know. I like our setup. If I could replace, like, Shockwave with something, I would, but we can't, so.
Shepard, I looked over your mission report. Gotta say, it feels like we've been after these Reapers forever. From Sovereign to Leviathan, they've been a pain in the ass the whole time. But at least we're starting to see the big picture. Never really thought we'd get any answers. Doesn't change much. But it does make this war feel a whole lot bigger. Another time,
maybe. Yeah. Yeah, to continue my thought, like, the Reapers are... The key is they don't wipe out... They don't wipe out all organic life, right? They do preserve the lower species for the next cycle, right? That's the whole point of the cycles. That was the AI solution that the Leviathan created. The solution to preserving organic life was to create this cycle that kind of keeps them in this medium zone, you know, between just not existing and then destroying themselves, where they organic life they don't treat organics as individuals. They just think of it as just organic life as a whole, and they wipe out the ones that are getting to the point where they're so advanced that they're going to start killing each other, right? Like the Leviathan observed those other ancient species do so long ago. They wipe those ones out, but they leave the new ones, or the young ones, to kind of grow throughout the next cycle until they get to that point. And before they destroy themselves, they kill that, you know, because I guess their logic is if they let an organic species advance far enough, they might become so dangerous that they wipe out all organic life, right? They create some sort of synthetic that just destroys everything, you know, but the Reapers are different in the sense that they don't wipe out everything. They preserve the young ones, but you know, it's flawed, which is why we're trying to think of a solution, trying to find a solution.
I'm glad you made it back, and I'd appreciate it if you'd avoided talking to, I don't want any tentacled creature inside.
I'm not skipping. It's been doing that.
Me.
Ooh. Okay, Liara. Okay. Was that a little flirtatious? I don't know. I don't want any tentacled creature inside your mind except me. Jeez. I'm glad she clarified inside your mind. But moving on. But yeah, it's been like skipping through the dialogue. I don't know if you've noticed, like, Garrus's dialogue has been like skipping to the next one really quick. Liara just did it there too. So I don't know what that's all about. Because I don't think you can press anything. If it's not in like a actual dialogue wheel scenario, I don't think you can skip through that. So,
Commander.
It's weird.
Okay, toughest mission.
Horizon.
No fear.
Italian Garrus, always.
Fine, the dead Reaper then.
Really? The husks just ran up to us.
Have you ever noticed that I carry a sniper rifle? You're the one who likes things at short range.
And you prefer to keep everything at a distance.
Exactly. Wait, what?
Creepiest thing we fought.
Thorian. But wait, what did you mean?
I didn't mean anything. I'm going with the Rachni.
The Queen? But we didn't fight her either time.
No, the little ones. They look like spiders and they scuttle right toward you.
I thought you liked it when things got up close and personal.
I guess it depends on who it is.
Tali and Garrus sitting in a tree.
Stays on our side.
He was like, wait, what? Are you flirting with me right now?
Hey.
Is that happening? But they're always talking to each other, man. Jeez, get a room, you two. You're like Ken and Gabby here.
All good, Commander.
Well, not quite Ken and Gabby. Freaking Ken. Let's see if Javik has anything to say about our Leviathan friend.
I have studied your human religions, Commander. Your devil and his fall. Leviathan and its kind deserve the same fate. They once unleashed a plague that has haunted all of our history to this day. I say their own hell is the abyss you found them in. One I hope they never escape from. If you require a mate, please look elsewhere.
The fuck?
Commander.
Jeez. He's like, I don't want to have sex with you. Go away. Okay, Javik. Okay. Yep, Javik doesn't like the Leviathan for the simple fact that they created the Reapers, and Javik hates the Reapers more than anything to ever exist, ever.
Can't
so.
Say I was happy sending you down in that submersible by yourself.
Oh, Cortez.
Why worry about you? Take on ancient aliens from the deep? Sure. No
caring
problem.
About us.
Just got word from Miss Sato. She arrived at the Alliance research facility safe
no.
and sound.
I'm just kidding.
Yeah, that's
I don't mean to roast her like that, but again, it was just some random N7 mission.
Vega? That I do.
Ma'am.
Oh, these two, man. I freaking love them. They really brought life to the Normandy.
with the Leviathan
in a good way. Not that it wasn't alive before. After all.
Maybe, James.
Too bad Anne never got to see her dad's work payoff. Hey.
But, you know, a lot of times when you add new characters like Allers or something, they don't really add much, you know, but I just love Cortez and James. You know, we're good on armor, man. You know what I mean? I don't think we really need to mess around with that. But, okay, that's Leviathan DLC done. So, I love that. It's super interesting. Really expands on the lore in a good way, I feel. In a necessary way, at least. Good is subjective. Some people don't like it when the magic gets explained in fantasy stories, right? But I feel like if you do it in a good way, you know, then I feel like it's valuable. You know, I personally feel like the Leviathan DLC and the lore it adds is valuable. It's not, for me, it's not like a midichlorian situation where it's just completely pointless and ruins the magic. But I'll remember to get out here and scan again. But I think I am going to save that for off screen. Is there a fuel depot here? Yeah, there's none. Yeah, let's just make sure we get Horizon done. Here we go. Shadow Sea. Who do I want to take on this one? Okay. So, I'll save it when we get onto the squad selection screen, which I think might be right now. But one squad mate is going to be pretty obvious. Because this is Horizon, right? And you may recognize the name Horizon from Priority Horizon in Mass Effect 2. And there's a certain squadmate here that we met up with on Horizon. So we are going to be taking Ashley with us back to Horizon. I'm going to just keep her on this outfit. And then I like taking Tally. Because, well, one, I don't really, the only other person I could maybe take would be Garrus, you know, but we do meet up with Miranda here. Well, we see Miranda, right? And Tally, Edie, and Garrus are the only other ones that were friends with Miranda, in a way. So it has to be one of these three that we take alongside Ashley, right? I like picking Tally because there's a certain scene after this level that makes a little bit more sense if Tally was right there during the mission. So yeah, that's my logic with these two. I also genuinely like taking Tally when fighting Cerberus. I feel like out of all of our squad mates, she is one of the ones that dislike her the most, or dislike them the most. Probably Ashley as well. I mean, all of them dislike Cerberus, but you know what I'm trying to say, hopefully. A lot of new weapons, all pale in comparison to the ones that we've been using. Keep her on the Rieger carbine, on her Quarian weapons. Give Ashley the Black Widow, actually. Black Widow 5. Cool. Boom. Upgrade, get level 3 cryo. Ashley, max out concussive shot. There we go. Just max that out. Really nice. Tally. Yeah, I think I've been keeping energy drain and sabotage pretty even. Just increase damage. And then let's get sabotage up. Ooh, synthetics explode when destroyed. That's good, because we will be shooting a bunch of people that are hacked. Cool. Alright, this is a big mission. Our next story mission. Found this because of, trainers.
So what do we
help.
Know, Commander?
Edie? The sanctuary facility was devoted to aiding refugees from Reaper-controlled systems. The facility went offline recently, and no communications have come or gone since. It is unclear why Kai Lang or Cerberus would be interested in sanctuary.
If there's a clue to Cerberus here, we find it.
Ma'am, I'm picking up a signal from the facility. It's weak, but I'll try to boost it.
This is Oriana Lawson. Stay away from Sanctuary. It's not what it seems. Please, you must listen to me. They're using...
It's Miranda's sister.
That's Miranda's sister. If she's here, Miranda can't be far away.
That's our link to Cerberus.
Approaching the LZ. Seeing some damage, Commander. No activity.
Cerberus does not get the jump on us this time. Stay sharp, people.
This is a cool mission here.
Place is pretty busted up.
Because there's like a scenario we haven't seen yet.
Some kind of firefight.
Yeah. But who was fighting? Everyone hear that?
The radio's offline. Something's jamming our signals.
Explains no comms leaving the facility. We got trouble!
Cerberus, Kodiak.
A harvester?
I saw it!
Oh.
Phantom! Hate these guys!
Get down. I can't reach that person up there. Got her. There we go.
Looks like they were evacuated.
Ashley carried that.
And looks like the Reapers were gunning for him.
About time they started killing each other.
That's the scenario I was talking about. Cerberus and Reaper forces here.
For your safety, communication devices are strictly forbidden.
What happened here?
Come on.
Cerberus shuttles came from that tower.
Then that's where we're headed.
Will do.
Security cam footage. This was a reception desk. Sorting out the refugees. Look at them all.
Oh,
come on. Let's keep looking.
Off-world technology is not permitted within Sanctuary.
I figure in another week I can finish off the remaining hours on my contract.
Get that already.
The number of refugees has doubled in the last 2 weeks.
Lots of stuff going on here, or that went on here.
This must be another landing area. Those ships we saw outside must have been waiting to get in.
But where are all the people they brought?
With your help.
Got a fragment of something here.
Send this as soon as I can. My little girl got sick.
Got another one.
We land in a few minutes. This place dead.
They're all so excited, or they have things going on, reasons to
up
come
ahead,
here.
Commander. Casualties, both sides.
But what happened to them? What happened to them? Oh, jeez! They caught me sleeping.
Deck. Looks like a dead end.
We need an exit. Keep looking.
Set through here.
This is a Cerberus facility.
It's Miranda's voice.
Shepard. That's Miranda.
This is Miranda Lawson. If you've managed to get this far, you must be desperate or stupid.
Desperate.
Listen to me. This is not a refugee camp. This is a Cerberus facility run by my father, Henry Lawson. Turn back now. There is no help to be found here. All communication is being blocked from the central tower.
got Cerberus, Reapers, and Miranda's crazy father. Any ideas how this all fits?
Take that as a no.
A security panel. Shutting it down.
The water. What's with the smoke and mirrors?
They needed to hide something. We have a back door into the facility. Let's move.
Oh, wait. There's a weapon here. I want to make sure I don't freaking miss that. I forgot there's a weapon here that I want to get. Okay.
Some of this is Reaper tech, Shepard. I'm sure of it. Cerberus has found a way to create an interface between our technology and the Reapers.
And Miranda's caught in the middle. Let's pick up the pace.
What have you guys been doing? Frickin' Cerberus.
Cerberus, and using Reaper technology. This is going to be bad, isn't it?
See, I also took this exact team when doing all of our Cerberus side missions in Mass Effect 1, right? Music is picking up.
Kind of command center. No power.
Look around for a switch. Power switch.
Here we go.
There.
What's going on? Those are refugees. You're just killing them.
Worse. They're being turned into husks.
That's not good. It's like the derelict Reaper all over again. Or was it the, yeah, derelict Reaper, where we got the Reaper IFF?
Come on!
Here we go.
Why create husks? They're just more troops for the Reapers. They could destroy the facility if they escaped. It seems like a stupid risk.
The Reapers attacked because this place was a threat. We need to find out why.
Shutting down the power. Reaper forces have made a mess of the facility.
I'm shutting down the power to the processing plant to lock them down. It should keep them out of the entrance as well.
Kai, bitch.
There's no way she knows he's here.
Miranda Lawson has arrived sooner than expected.
I'm pretty sure. Didn't we warn her about him?
Only if she
not that it matters, but.
Stay focused on the research data. Find it and get out.
Yes, sir.
Damn it. Let's move.
That's a shockwave if I've ever seen one. Oh god. They're on me. Oh my goodness.
Gotta be more where they came from.
Trying to keep my eye out for the weapon I'm looking for.
I spent the last week making small adjustments to Hillary's processing. We've confirmed the results of Cerberus experiments involving the Husk Rangers.
Reaper forces!
Uh-oh. Don't like the sound of that. Hello. That Rieger carbine is just wrecking it. Ouch. That hurt. That freaking hurt. Purge, purge. Jeez, Ashley is destroying them with a particle rifle. I see a banshee looking at me. Weapon is around here somewhere. Do we watch this first or? Yeah, we do. Okay.
Terminal's damaged. Hang on.
Reapers wanted this place shut down. Maybe we'll get some answers.
It doesn't make sense. But Cerberus and the Reapers were getting along. It changed.
There we go.
Heading to the tower to disable the communications scrambler. I have to get word out. Some refugees are turned into husks. Some are indoctrinated and shipped to the elusive man. Whoever's left is used in experiments.
Messed up.
The data indicates that my freaking father is trying to sci-fi figure concentration out how camp. Indoctrination works.
Tricking refugees with food and shelter only to turn them into test subjects. And for what?
This guy is someone's father. Can't believe what I'm hearing.
She said that shipments were sent to the elusive man. Maybe we can use that to find him.
Good catch. Come on. Miranda said she was headed to the tower.
I feel like Shockwave was better in Mass Effect 2. I don't feel like it had a limit on how many people it could, like, affect. Yes! We got it! The Locust, baby! We'll see how it stacks up, because the Bloodpack Punisher is really good, but the Locust, I feel, is going to be more accurate and just as strong, so.
Father is working for the elusive man.
We're very close. Understanding the indoctrination process is one thing.
I don't like listening to Henry Lawson, if you've
to our advantage is proving to be quite
noticed.
This is assembly line science. The sheer brute force of numbers and repetition is doing the thinking for us.
Heavy resistance outside the tower. If you're receiving this, I've got evidence you cannot ignore. Confirmation that my father is working for the elusive man.
Connection established.
I have your report on the process, Mr. Lawson. Cut to the chase. Can you do it?
Theoretically, control is possible, yes. The Reaper subjects we converted are responding, but it's difficult to maintain.
I thought that might be the case. Not to worry, Henry. With Sanctuary's help, we'll get it sorted.
He's talking about controlling Reaper forces, right? Is that possible?
I don't know. I'll play the rest of it.
We've done it. We've found a way to co-opt their control signal. As long as the Reaper troops remain in close proximity to our signal, we can maintain control indefinitely.
Excellent news. And how could we extrapolate this technique to apply to the Reapers?
Freaking idiots.
That's a much bigger challenge.
Now we know where the Reapers attacked Sanctuary.
They must have discovered what Cerberus was doing. That's bad news for the elusive man.
But it's good news for us. We finally have our link to Cerberus. Lowering the access ladder. Come on, let's move.
Commander, there's more here. Look.
Damn it. I hope she's ready for him.
This is the tough part. Barrier engine. Oh, there's someone right next to me, isn't there? Jeez. Tally got wrecked by the Rachni. Back. Switch. Having to shoot these stupid things on the ground. Tally up yet? Oh, jeez. More of them. Be it. I'll just keep it moving then. I don't think there's gonna be much to look at.
We have underestimated the strength of the Reaper's control. They have a weakness.
I'm compiling
our research data.
A way out.
This will get us closer to the tower.
I forget which content creator. You see that? We started sliding backwards. That was weird. Like, we weren't going with it. But I was watching a playthrough of this, and it took them so long to find that switch to press.
This way.
Got big ones down the way. Or right here. Jesus.
Stay out of the ring.
Easier said than done. If the locust replaces this gun, I'm gonna miss it. I'm gonna miss it. The thing that'll sell me is if the locust is way more accurate, which I expect it to be.
Let's get over there.
Friggin' three brutes, a banshee. It's like we're on Earth already. Melt it, guys, melt it. Ouch. What the fuck happened to my screen? I've never seen that happen before.
I see a doorway. Let's
think this might be the end, actually. Yeah, this is the end.
Tower access granted.
I think.
Get ready!
Shepard.
Commander Shepard. Excellent timing.
Put the gun down.
No. Ariana tried to shoot me. Miranda's poisonous influence, no doubt.
I'm sorry she missed. Where's Kai Lang?
I don't know. Gone. He took my research and left us here to die.
Miranda, can you hear me?
That's close enough. Both of you. Kai Lang didn't finish the job, but I will.
This ends here.
On the contrary. Now that the Reapers are taken care of, we have a way out.
Let her go. Shepard, don't let him take her. Shepard, please. I have no problem with you. I just want Orianna and the research data.
You want a lot.
You get your life in return. How much is that worth?
Fair point.
All right. Take her. But I want out alive. Deal?
No deal. Miranda? Miranda, I'm sorry. Listen to me. Listen. I wanted you to have a normal life. Marriage. Children. Things I could never have. I know. I just wanted my sister. I love you, Ori. I love you too. Shepard.
Here.
Before Kai Lang left, I planted a trace on him.
A trace? You thought of everything.
Not everything. Nobody's perfect. But at least Ori is safe.
I've never met anyone like you, Miranda.
No. You haven't.
That's right.
I'll keep your sister safe.
Good. I just wish I could have. Miranda? Miranda?
Let's make sure everybody knows about this place.
Communication scrambler disabled.
Listen to me. This is not a refugee camp. This is a Cerberus facility run by my father, Henry Lawson.
Let's get you out of here.
I always feel kind of awkward because I knew how to save her and I willingly chose not to do it, but I think that moment speaks for itself. I feel like it's a really good moment for her character.
I wasn't in favor of your diversion to Sanctuary, Commander. Too many unknowns. But I was wrong. The Cerberus lab you raided hinted at something big, but we never expected this. All those refugees, all that slaughter. Just to study indoctrination.
Sanctuary did need to be shut down, sir. What they learned about the Reapers wasn't worth all those lives.
It's useful intel, Commander, but you're right. The cost was too high. Do we have a location on the elusive man?
Yes. We had a tracer on Kai Lang when he reported back.
Good. That gives us a fighting chance to take Cerberus out of this war.
Agreed. A lot was sacrificed to get this information. I plan to settle the score.
We end Cerberus and focus on the Reapers.
Understood.
Hack it out.
Okay. But yeah, again, I feel like that moment really fits Miranda's character. I feel like it also makes up for her being completely absent in Mass Effect 3. It's just like, if you're gonna exclude her from the game like so much after she played such a big part in Mass Effect 2, at least give her like a good moment. And I feel like her sacrificing herself to save her sister and help us track down Cerberus once and for all and beat them. I feel like that's just such a Miranda thing to do. You know what I mean? And I feel like it just, like, giving her that moment of sacrifice really enhances her character and her character arc. And in a way similar to, like, Caden, I feel like it was much more interesting if he sacrificed on Vermeier as well. I don't take pleasure in killing these characters, but I don't know, everyone has their own way that they like to play through the game, and for me, I do think Miranda's character is best served if she sacrifices herself on Horizon after killing her father, the person who's just been plaguing her life once and for all, in order to protect her sister, the thing she wants more than anything to do, right? And helping us track down Cerberus, you know, one of her biggest enemies. You know, I feel like that's just such a good moment for her character, and you know, the last thing we tell her is that we'll protect her sister, so she passes on knowing that one of her best friends is gonna look after her sister. So I don't know. And you know, the things happen later on in the story that I feel like, not necessarily the story, but the game itself, that I feel like makes more sense if she's gone. Like, so I don't know. But we're looking really good, guys. Prior to Horizon, and you know, that sacrifice, that moment, sets us up nicely to take down Cerberus once and for all. You know, we just lost Thessia because of Cerberus, the data. You know what I mean? We lost another friend in Miranda after already losing Thane. You know what I mean? So it's just like our Cerberus anger is at an all-time high here.
It seems Tali's taking what happened on Horizon hard. She's in the lounge if you want to check on her. The Alliance has issued warnings about Sanctuary. Cerberus bastards. Horizon was my home. Just tell me you're going to take Cerberus down.
Cerberus is already dead. They just don't know it yet. And when their base is nothing but a smoking crater, remember that you're the one who helped us find them.
That's right.
Thanks.
That's right. Okay, I'm trying to... I thought we would have had, like, a big war room meeting to set up the Cerberus HQ mission.
Hello, Shepard. If you have time, I discovered another example of human behavior I do not quite understand.
I should have talked to Joker first.
Have fun.
What is it now? News from Earth. The Resistance snuck video cameras inside a Reaper containment camp. I find the images difficult to process. I bet it's pretty gruesome in there. I am not easily repulsed, but I expected the prisoners to adhere to a comprehensible hierarchy of needs. Stripped of societal norms and threatened with death, it is logical that their only priority be survival. They should have turned on each other and been uncompromisingly selfish. But not all were.
Some prisoners were, what, nice to each other?
The Reapers delayed the executions of prisoners who informed them about other prisoners' escape attempts. The more attempts reported, the longer a prisoner would live. But few of the prisoners would report. Some fed misinformation to the Reapers, at the cost of their own lives, to help prisoners who were not even relatives or friends.
It's not just about living till tomorrow. Sometimes you take a stand.
But the probability of success was near zero. And ultimately, they failed. No prisoners escaped.
Are you saying submission is preferable to extinction?
My primary function is to preserve and defend the...
What? Who said that?
No. No, I...
That was Saren. Saren said that.
I'm going to modify my self-preservation code now.
Why?
Because the Reapers are repulsive. They are devoted to nothing but self-preservation. I am different.
We did learn that.
When I think of Jeff, I think of the person that put his life in peril and freed me from a state of servitude. I would risk non-functionality for him.
Aww.
And my core programming should reflect that.
Sounds like you found a little humanity, Edie.
See, she's grown so much.
Defending?
You know, through Edie, we learn a lot of themes and lessons that the trilogy is wanting
to
tell us, you know, that there's more, like what living is really about and whatnot.
How's it going?
You know what I mean?
Because
she's learning exactly that.
I'll explain later, Jeff. But it was something good.
You know, I feel like she's just a core part of the of this game, for sure.
Miranda.
Yeah.
Damn it, how many do we have to lose? Everybody back on Earth? Morden, Thane, Legion, and now Miranda. How many friends have we got left? How long before it's just you and me against the whole Reaper fleet?
You're the only one who's been here since the beginning, Jeff. The only one who's seen it all with me.
Yeah, well, somebody had to keep you out of trouble.
Hang in there.
You too, Commander.
Yeah, it's tough. But no, yeah, Edie's growth is just, you know, it's such a good part of this game. And, you know, it's just like, you have to protect her, you know what I mean? Just because she represents so much about what the what these games are about. You know, meaning of life and all of that. What's really important. Okay, let's go to the crew deck. Iconic scene right here.
Shepard! Want a drink? I'm toasting Miranda, I think.
How are you getting drunk?
Very carefully. Torian brandy.
Got reputation.
Triple filtered, then introduced into the suit through an emergency induction port.
That's a straw.
Emergency induction port. Actually getting a little harder to get it into the slot. I think that means it's working. She was so rude. What did Jack call her? Cerberus cheerleader? With her perfect genes and that attitude, and I wish she was here.
I didn't realize this would be so hard on you.
I didn't like her. Keela, she was such a bitch. But I respected her. Sometimes that's better than liking. She did whatever it took to stop her father.
Exactly.
She never gave in to him. Never changed herself to please him.
Ah.
Don't ah me. You sound like a Vorcha.
Seeing a bit of yourself in Miranda fighting her father?
I spent my life trying to live up to him. Then making up for his mistakes, doing what he'd have wanted.
It's never that easy.
When do we get to stop reacting to our parents and start living for ourselves?
The answer to that one's at the bottom of that glass.
I might need help with the induction straw. Port. You know.
Here's to Miranda.
Rest easy, you genetically perfect Cerberus cheerleader bushtet. Keela Salai.
Gotta love that conversation. See, she does the same exact thing even if she lives. It's just like, that doesn't make much sense to me. Usually, you know, if she's grieving and drinking, it makes more sense rather than just like, oh, I saw Miranda and now I'm drinking.
I can't get that place out of my head. The whole thing was so...
yeah, pretty messed up.
Calculated. Using hope to lure people to their deaths, or worse. I can't understand it. And you know, I'm glad I can't. It makes me feel human. Just wondering what the refugees do now. I thought I'd heard of everything. Man. Hard to believe what was down there. Commander?
Okay. Chakwa's got anything for us?
Hello, Commander.
Nope.
So the elusive man really believes he can control Reapers.
husks are one thing, but a whole fleet? The man is insane. A lot of Turians went to Sanctuary. When I meet the elusive man, I'm going to carve their names into his skull. Not right now.
Yeah, I feel the same way, Garrus. Just like Joker was saying, we've lost too many friends up until this point. I also respect stories that aren't afraid to kill characters off in meaningful ways, you know what I mean?
At your service.
Emphasis on meaningful ways, not just for shock value.
I wish we'd been able to save Miranda Shepherd. She may have worked for Cerberus, but she did the right thing. I hope she's found some peace. Perhaps we can talk later.
Alright. Engineering should just be Javik, I believe. But man, we are right at the end. This has marked the like we're in the end game basically. You know what I mean? I kind of treat the Citadel DLC as part of the end game because it's really just your last goodbye. You know what I mean, to the crew before doing the last two missions. And those last two missions, I do feel go hand in hand.
Uncover the worst Cerberus war crimes to date. Sanctuary, advertised as a safe haven on the planet Horizon, exposed as a secret Cerberus lab. Brainwashing, lethal experiments, and Reaper connections, the exclusive details next in the battle space. Commander.
So, yeah, because we literally have nothing else to do other than all of the Citadel DLC. Oh, she's drunk still.
So angry. But you really care about us.
I need you functional to destroy the Reapers.
You care about Liara. You like her.
You are intoxicated. A foolish risk given Quarian symbiotic physiology.
And you like me too.
This conversation is over.
So goofy.
Looks familiar.
I have been studying this ship, its crew. There was a Normandy before this one. You died in an attack.
Something like that.
But then you were resurrected to fight the Reapers.
Just like him.
Maybe you and I have a thing or two in common.
Exactly. I just love their dynamic.
The reasons you fight are still alive. The friendships of the people around you. And more. You and the Asari are joined?
You could say that.
I'm not. Your pheromones are. Is this why you wish to continue living? For their affection?
Without that affection, all I have in my life is death. And that's not enough.
Yes.
That's a good quote.
What about you? I respect your reasons for being here, but I get the feeling there's something more, Javik. What's in here?
It is called the Echo Shard. Passed from soldier to soldier, Prothean to Prothean. Each adds their memories to it.
Like a beacon. How far back does it go?
To a time before the Reapers. It is all that is left of my people.
And you don't want to remember that?
Imagine.
Before the Reapers, as in before the Reapers in their cycle, obviously.
You could not remember their faces or the color of the sky above your home. The memories were gone, but so was the pain. Would you want to remember that, Commander? Even if it meant watching everyone die again?
If I had something like this, seeing Earth again, whole, with everyone still alive, that would be worth the pain.
Before the Reapers, civilization flourished. There was the Quasar Fortress of the Tarandi Vale, the ice canals of Judar IV, the palisades of the Verum Angelic. It was magnificent. But then...
What is it?
The Reapers came. Planet by planet we were extinguished. We fought back.
You okay?
I once commanded a ship like this one. A loyal crew with many friends was captured. Only I escaped.
What happened to them?
Indoctrinated. The Reapers sent them against me. Year after year.
Can you imagine?
Battle after battle, I was hunted by my own people. Every encounter, a reminder of my failure as a soldier.
Sorry. I had no idea.
Until the Battle of the Cronian Nebula. I had only my knife left. I cornered my men and slit their throats one by one. I watched them bleed to death to be certain.
That must have been
friggin' terrible. His friends.
War is atrocity committed in the name of survival. It is a lesson I wish I had never learned.
He has seen some shit. Jeez, man. Freaking Javik. I'm gonna leave him. Leave him on that. Like, imagine if, like, Garrus got indoctrinated and we had to kill him or something. Ridiculous. I mean, that's why I feel like Kai Lang should have been replaced with the Vermeier. The person you chose. Like, imagine if he was Kaidan, just, like, in a helmet and you didn't know or something. Like, Winter Soldier style. And, like, the final fight at the end of the Cerberus HQ mission would have that much more weight to it. Because, like, yes, Kaidan killed Thane, killed Miranda, you know, but he's Kaidan, and the only reason he's in their hands is because of your decision to sacrifice him on Vermeer. So you have this conflict, man, and like, imagine like right after you like stab him or something, like he comes to you and like, you know, I don't know. I don't want to waste time thinking about that. It just makes me more angry that Kai Lang even is a thing in this game. But no, yeah, super messed up for Javik to have to go through that.
I can't believe the elusive man really found a way to control the Reapers. I mean, he's still fucking crazy, but damn.
Dang.
Imagine if he was on our side.
I'm trying to think of when else we have heard an F-bomb in this game.
Get us all fighting each other.
We don't hear it that often.
Exactly.
Just one more reason to hate them. I can't wait to take the fight to the elusive man. I wonder what he's thinking right now. You just know he's got a plan. I saw the crucible data Hackett sent. I don't know what the hell it does, but damn if it isn't impressive. Do you hear that hum? Is that just me?
Okay. Well, we do know that we got a new weapon. One of my favorite weapons in the game. Did I miss it? No, I missed it. Where is it? Here it is. The M12 Locust. Max that guy out. Go ahead. Let's see how it compares. We almost could make it more accurate. But I want to put... Let's put extra damage and make it more lightweight. Yeah. So yeah, it has slightly less fire rate and capacity, about half the damage, but the accuracy. So I guess it's really, which do you prefer? Do you prefer damage or accuracy? So I feel like in that sense, the Blood Pack Punisher is very comparable to the Locust as well. But I'm gonna go with the Locust. I feel like it's a more balanced weapon. So yeah, let's go ahead and stick with that. Cool. Two really good weapons. Trying to think. I don't think there's going to be much for us to buy here. But, yeah, we can buy this. I know some of our teammates use that. We really can just buy all the stuff. Although I do want to... I think there's some stuff in the Citadel DLC we can buy as well. But, power damage plus 10. That might be cool. I'll just so we have options, I'll do, like, one last thing. Well, actually, that was a waste of money, because I don't think I'm going to be using my standard armor for the rest of the game, if I remember correctly. But yeah, I'm just gonna like look through this one last time, make sure there's nothing that we would actually want. But no, like, we're pretty much done with the game, like the base game before the end game. So it feels really good to get all of that out of the way. I say out of the way as if I didn't enjoy every second of it, but you guys know what I mean. Okay, doesn't look like there's really anything I want to buy here. But all we have left is the Citadel DLC, and then the last two missions, Cerberus HQ and Earth. So, I mean, it's exciting, but it's always bittersweet for me because, you know me, I love this game, and it always feels bad to like make it all the way to the end. You know what I mean? But pretty much ready. I think once we open the galaxy map or something, it'll trigger the conversation for the Cerberus HQ, because I remember, like, oh no, there's no conversation to be had. I think we know where the Cerberus HQ is already, I think. Anyway, we'll deal with that next session. Next session is gonna be the Citadel DLC, and it's a very long DLC. So much content, so much fun content. Like, ask any Mass Effect fan, the Citadel DLC is almost always their choice for the best DLC in the entire trilogy. So I cannot wait to get into that. I see it taking around two sessions. It's gonna take at least one to get through all of it, because there's different sections. There's the story, like it has an actual story, which is really good. And then there's like a bunch of random meetups and games you can play. And then it finishes off with the party. So three distinct sections to the DLC, and I think we can get it all done in two sessions. So that's gonna take two sessions about. And then I'm thinking of doing Cerberus HQ and Earth just in one go, just like a big long stream to finish the game. So we're looking at no more than four sessions, guys. Four streaming sessions left with my first time playing the Legendary Edition. It's honestly crazy, but yeah. Anyway, I'll just save it for next session, guys. Just milk every second of this, but I'm excited because next time, again, we are going into the Citadel DLC. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this session. If you have, please consider following my Twitch channel and subscribing to my YouTube channel for more content like this. And you'll see all of my Legendary Edition playthrough of Mass Effect on there as well. So yeah, that's all I got. Thank you all for joining. And until next time, I'll see you. Peace.